friend. What do you know about my boys? Please, I have a custody decree here, a court order. It's all legal. You want to see the papers?
No. Why don't we find someplace?
Jeremy is into soccer. He wears his uniform everywhere. And, Ronald keeps losing his new glasses because he thinks they make him look dorky, which they don't. And they're good kids. And Carl has told them that you're dead. And they believe this?
Yes.
Who are you? What do you want?
I want the truth.
Okay, say goodbye to the house. Is that supposed to make me feel better?
The first day of the rest of our lives.
Mom, what we're homeless.
It'll be okay, honey.
You'll see.
I'm sorry, honey. I really thought that I could make it work on our own.
Well, we made it for 6 months without Dad's help. That's pretty good.
Yeah, good old Haywood.
Living with Grandma might be fun.
Oh, it's not exactly my idea of happily ever after.
What did you tell her?
As little as possible. When we get there, I'll sit her down one-on-one and make it clear that this is only temporary, you know, until we get back on her feet.
She'll want to know more than that.
Yeah. Oh, God, the whole family's here.
Can you believe this?
Oh,
Holly.
Yeah.
Hey, Holly.
Hey, Holly. Look what the cat dragged in. Was she talking to Mama?
What are you talking about? We're family.
Oh, honey.
Hi.
My goodness.
Honey,
good to see
her.
Come on. Good to see you too, Bobby. Oh, you're getting tall. You're getting as tall as I am.
It's a dance floor. It's a party.
Yeah, it's a party. Look how tall you got. You're still short, though. Come on, I gotta get you some food. Morning.
When are we gonna tell Dad where we are?
Anytime you want. You know where he is. You know, I envy you. I love junior high school.
Yeah, well, you can take my place.
I bet I could. I've still got the legs.
Go ahead.
Now, come on, don't be like that. This is hard for me, too, you know. At least you know where you're going to school. I still have to find myself a job.
Yeah, well, I liked my school.
You know, I liked my home, too, but I'm not the reason we had to leave.
Yeah, well, you're the one who pushed for the divorce.
Excuse me? Fine. But if that's the way it is, at least get your facts straight. He is the one who left. I am the one who stayed.
There she is again. You say her name is Holly?
Holly. Holly Mitchell.
She just moved back to town. Works as a private nurse.
Hey, can you give me a hand here, please?
I'd be happy to. Here, let me get that for you. It smells good. What are you, feeding an army?
Something like that. Don't bother, I got it.
My name's Carl Gibbons. Those are my boys over there, Joey and Robbie. We're new in town.
Holly Mitchell, thank you.
I know. I was wondering if maybe we could get together sometime. But my realtor told me that your family knows everybody in the area, and since I'm opening a new business, Hey, Joey, get your brother down from there. Robbie, get down, please. Thank you. Kids.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much, but...
How about if I said strictly business?
Really? No, thanks.
Well, it's okay. It's okay. I've heard no before. But you're making a mistake.
What kind of business are you starting here?
It's going to be a general store, modern, but a little old-fashioned, kind of like me.
You know, I have brothers.
You want me to ask one of them out?
Sure. 555-0062. Good luck.
0062.
Truth.
Really? I'll remember that.
I'm 13. You can talk to me.
I do, honey, all the time.
Not on an interpersonal level, you don't.
What, have you been reading Cosmo?
Well, it's true.
Nothing happened on any level, and you shouldn't believe everything you read. Don't tell you cook this whole dinner yourself.
Just calm down. Yes, I did.
You did? Well, I think the chicken's getting cold.
What, do you want me to eat it up?
Not while I'm sitting on the ground.
Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you.
At least this one cleans up good.
Stop it, Richard.
Observation, nothing more.
Is that for me? Thank you. Oh, that is beautiful. Thank you very much, Robbie. Thank you very much. My family is suspicious of my taste in men. I've told you my first husband was no prize, and that's putting it kindly, so just give them time.
Oh, I did. I gave them watches. I just want them to like me.
They will.
What about you? What about you?
No,
I don't want to have my picture.
No, you should be in this.
I hate to have my picture.
Why?
I take a lousy picture? Come on.
How could
much
you?
Much prettier with you in it, please. Here. Scissors.
Okay, everybody
scissors,
get together.
For the ribbon. Oh, scissors thanks. For the ribbon. Okay.
Okay, everybody together.
Ready? Joey, Robbie, get together.
On three.
All righty, let's go. One, two, three.
Three.
Here we go. Perfect. Great.
I think I closed my eyes, Dad.
You want to do it one more time?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go.
Come on, Holly, let's not spoil our day.
It won't spoil our day.
Yes, it will.
What are you afraid of?
I'm not afraid of anything.
Then why won't you tell me about her?
Okay. It was a perfect marriage. I worked, she drank, we never saw each other.
Don't tell me, forget it.
Oh, come on, honey, we were miserable.
Forget it.
Now, she got very ill. You know what it's like when they tell you? I mean, the worse the news is, the smaller the sentence they use. And when the news is really, really bad, they just use one word, inoperable.
Are you saying she died?
No.
Carl, why didn't you tell me?
Well, it's not something I've had a lot of practice at, Holly. I mean, there was Rayanne, and now there's you. It's a hard thing to bring up at the beginning of a relationship.
So what was it?
Well, it's just a tiny speck on a CAT scan. Anyway, afterwards, I just felt like the boys needed a fresh start, you know. A place without memories, a place where the sun shines. And then the company said Rose Hill, and I said, yes, I mean, based on the name alone. Our marriage was over long before she got sick.
I'm sorry. I'm glad you told me.
Me too.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Are you
Bunny.
You'd let me borrow that?
Yeah. It's in the car.
Why don't you go get that for me, okay? Wait. First, you have to come here and give me a big hug. Come on. Now, why don't you go get me that blue bunny, okay? All right, hurry up. Don't get lost.
Holly.
Hi, Joey. What is it? What's wrong?
I don't like this.
Why not? That's a great suit. You look very handsome in it.
I don't like it.
All right, then why don't you come in here, sit down, and we'll talk about it. So, if it's not this suit, then what?
Well, Dad said no, and he says no.
Well, right now you're talking to me, so why don't you ask me?
With tenderness, with care, with love and understanding, the relationship that you will begin with these vows shall grow in beauty and in truth because you have nurtured them. And now, in the eyes of God and the state of North Carolina, I now pronounce you man and wife. you may kiss the bride.
Carl, we may be slow to warm up to, but once you get to know us, I promise you we're a whole lot worse. Well, I'm the oldest, so I get to speak my mind and you get to sit there and like it. I have 3 children. And since Papa died, I like to think that each of them is carrying on his memory in some way. But in a lot of ways, it's you, Holly, who are really carrying on for him. You're the one who got what people love best about him. What we miss the most. Papa's big heart. The way he loved people and people loved him right back. Papa used to call her my little gem. You snared our one and only diamond, Carl. To my daughter and her husband, happiness forever.
Maybe it's time we all had a talk.
About what?
Well, about what to call each other, for one.
Pop says we should call you Mom.
Is that what you two decided? You know, I always wanted to have a son, and now I have 2, so I guess I got what I wanted. And maybe I'll just let you two decide, okay?
Okay. Are you and Daddy going to go away a lot?
I don't think so. Why, did you miss us?
A little.
That's okay. I know what it's like to miss someone. I mean, even when you're as old as me, you can miss somebody.
Who do you miss? Robbie.
It's okay. Well, the person I miss most is my daddy.
Where is he?
Now, he passed away. That's why I know what it's like.
You know, I've been to Atlantic City.
You have?
Yep. When we left Pennsylvania, we went there first.
Oh, you mean Connecticut, right?
Yeah. He's 9. To him, Hawaii's around the block.
Right. Okay. Bobby, Joey, my kids. Bye-bye, sweetie. Have a good day.
Bye.
I'm going to
show you around?
School's a school, right?
Honey, it's the finest school in the state. I mean, just think of all the lifelong friends she'll make there.
At 13, lifelong has very little meaning. Right now, her life is ruined.
So what do you want me to do about it?
I don't know yet. Hey. Since when do we rent furniture?
Well, since we moved in. How'd you get that?
It was in the mail today. Everything?
No, not everything, just a few things. I mean, it's easier than buying.
The bed?
The bed, no, the bed. The bed's, Salvation Army, I think. I'll take care of that. And I'll talk to Amanda, okay? I promise. Maybe I'll even buy her something. With diamonds.
You better not. At least not until you buy me something with diamonds.
Diamonds?
I was just,
These are my personal files. What were you looking for?
I was filing.
Filing?
Yeah, you got this telegram, and I was just going to...
If you need to see something in there, you ask me first.
No, like I said,
I don't need any filing done, Holly. What did you expect to find? Marriage is built on trust.
I know. I don't want to see your cards. If I see your cards, I might cheat. Yeah, I keep those close to your chest, okay?
Joey.
Rule number one, don't show anyone else
your cards.
You
have a 9.
A 9?
Yeah?
No.
Go fish.
Sorry.
Right. But are we all set now? Listen, did, my husband have this sort of mix-up at the Connecticut store? Yeah, Philadelphia, that's what I meant. Thank you.
I think it's time for Robbie to be promoted to bathroom janitor.
Yeah, we'll see what we can do. Joey, Joe, can I ask you something?
Sure.
You and Robbie don't, talk about your mother very much. What was she like?
Oh, I don't know. Like you in some ways.
Me?
Yeah.
I'm sure that's a wonderful compliment.
I'm gonna be late for soccer.
And that was in Connecticut, right?
He doesn't want us talking about it.
Who?
Daddy. He doesn't think it's good for us to dwell on the past.
You know, the more you and I get to know each other, the less secrets there'll be. We're family. Wasn't Connecticut, was it?
Get in the car.
your favorite stars.
You can sit there like a rain cloud. You're going to tell me what's troubling you.
Stop trying to read my mind, Mama.
I don't have to. It's all over your face.
Maybe I just want to sit here like mother and daughter. Is that so hard to imagine?
Fiddly sticks. Tell me. It's always the same expression.
Answer the phone, Mama.
I'd hope things would turn out differently with Carl. Mitchell's.
Grandma?
Oh, hi, honey. What's up?
Is Mama there?
Just a sec. It's Amanda.
Hi, baby.
Mama?
Come home now. Amanda?
I came home and they were packing.
What?
They're gone. Did we do something, Mama?
No, Mama, everything's fine. Delivery man, I had to sign for something. I will. You too. Bye.
We're not telling Grandma.
We're being considerate of her feelings. Besides, tomorrow there'll be nothing to explain anyway. What did he say again?
He said, aside from my boys, you and your mom are the best thing that ever happened to me. You're the daughter I always wanted. And then he drove away. So what now?
You go to school tomorrow.
School? You've got to be kidding.
No, I am not. I'm going to go look through the store, and I am sure I'm going to find an explanation. Hi, honey.
So how was your day?
On a scale of 1 to 10? I'm so sorry, honey. I thought it was gonna work out this time.
There's a river out there that you need moved, Holly. I'd like to help you.
All right, but it has to be completely confidential.
Understood.
I do not want to ruin Carl's good name in this town.
I know the perfect person. Owes me a favor.
Okay. Okay, and if it's all the same, I would like to call him myself.
Don't let Mike's personal peculiarities dissuade you. It's a dirty pond these people swim in. If Mike is the best there is in these parts.
He said he was from Connecticut, but you think it was Pennsylvania. Now he's missing, taking all his stuff, the kids, the family Bible, Aunt Minnie's picture, but you're not sure he's really missing.
That's right.
Well, there's a new wrinkle in the linen.
Excuse me?
Ma'am, matrimonial work is my stock and trade, my specialty, if you will. And when a wife tells me that she doesn't think her husband has really run off on her, when all of the evidence points to the contrary, it just runs against everything I know to be true.
Unless, of course, he's not really gone for good. There's always that possibility.
You one of the Mitchells farms tobacco up on Parson Weems Road?
Yes, Bobby's my brother.
You people as rich as everybody says you are?
No, but you'll get paid if that's what you're asking.
I got cherry and grape.
What about the orange?
I ate them.
No, thanks.
Let me take a stab here. You previously married?
Yes, she's dead.
Any bad blood in his past? You know, angry husband, irate business partner, things of that nature might have spooked him off.
That's why I'm here, Miss Wilwright, for you to find out. Gerard said you were good.
I'm better than good. But it's nice he says so. What's her name?
Who?
The dead wife.
Rayanne. Why?
Well, you gotta start someplace. That is, if we're in business.
We are, if you can assure me you'll be absolutely discreet. You see, my family has lived here for a very long time.
Now that, Mrs. Gibbons, sounds a lot more like it. I am the picture of discretion, I assure you. You just ask anyone.
Hi, honey.
Grandma's here.
How did you find out?
The realty office called me. We have an interest in Carl's building.
I just didn't want to worry you. I was going to tell you as soon as I knew for sure.
Really?
Yes.
I would have guessed that you'd know the signs by now.
What signs?
The signs of departure. But then, I should have known better myself. Who gives someone a watch the first time he meets you?
I didn't see you giving it back, Mama.
You don't see me wearing it either, do you? Give it back. Honestly, Holly, is that how you were brought up? Where have you been all this time anyway? Out. Think about what we talked about.
What did you and Grandma talk about?
Nothing.
Amanda.
She thinks that we should consider living with her.
And what did you say?
I didn't know what to
say. Well, next time she asks you, you tell her it's none of her business. You got that?
Changed his name. It's not Gibbons. It's Gilbane, the kids too. Ronald and Jeremy. Robbie and Joey aren't their real names.
Can I see that?
Sure.
Are you sure about this?
It's right there in black and white. Your husband's first wife was Rayanne Gilbane, born Rayanne Wicks of Philadelphia.
Pennsylvania.
Last time I checked. There are no tax filings for any of them in Connecticut. So no driver's license, traffic tickets, voter registration, etc., etc. They never lived there, is my guess. But that's not the big news. She's not dead. She's his ex. The divorce decree.
She's alive?
If you call working for the auto club alive, yeah, she's alive. I'm sorry to say, Mrs. Gibbons, but it seems your husband has not been fully honest with you. Can I get you something? A little water.
What about the boys?
He got sole custody 5 years ago.
What kind of woman would give up her kids?
Well, she must be something, all right. Although he's not exactly soup du jour either.
Did you say he's say 5 years?
Yeah, 5 years. Why?
Did you get a phone number?
No, that's gonna take some time.
Wait, not for him. Is this Rayanne Gilbane?
Speaking.
Were you once married to a Carl Gilbane?
Who is this? Who is this?
I know Carl. Is there somewhere we can meet? Oh, thank you, honey. My favorite.
Do I get to have an opinion about this?
Of course you do, honey. What kind of question is that?
This is beginning to scare me. I mean, lying to Grandma is one thing. But going off?
24 hours, that's all.
Men leave, Mama. Why can't you just accept that?
Honey, please.
He doesn't love us. I know, you're driving off to New Jersey?
Amanda, listen to me. I'm not leaving you. You are stuck with me. I'm going to be in your face when you're 105, making your life a living misery. But I have to do this. Can you understand that? 24 hours, that's it.
What do you know about my boys?
They're good kids. And Carl has told them that you're dead.
And they believe this?
Yes.
Who are you? What do you want?
I want the truth.
About what?
About Carl.
Call me in the middle of the night? You show up here like a private detective to ask me questions about Carl? Do you have a name?
Holly.
And I am supposed to, what, to tell you what a great guy Carl is?
I expected you to be angry.
Oh, I'm not angry. No, I could be if I wanted to, but I try to keep that at a minimum. No, I am in the each day is a new day stage. Perhaps you've heard of it.
Maybe this it's not a very good idea. I think I made a mistake.
Sit down. I'll tell you whatever you want. The truth, however, is rather overrated.
Not with me, is it?
Fine, I'll play.
Carl said some things.
I'll bet.
That you drank.
My last drink was in college. It was a gin and tonic. I liked it. It didn't like me. I have an enzyme imbalance in my blood.
Really?
Not much fun, this truth thing, huh? He will hurt you like you've never been hurt before, and then he will carry on as if you never even existed. That's the truth. Holly, you're the first lead I've had in 2 years. I haven't seen Ronald or Jeremy since Carl stole them.
Stole them?
Kidnapped, if you prefer.
When?
5 birthdays ago. 5 Christmases. 5 first days of school. My turn. Where are they?
I don't know.
Are you going to help me?
What do you mean?
Well, what do you think I mean?
No, look,
I answered your questions.
I'm sorry, I can't do this.
Sorry.
Please don't.
To be afraid of. You know, you say you want the truth, and then when the shoe's on the other foot, then you just run away. Think about that. It's no wonder your life is in such a mess. I'm not the one to run from here.
Why does he do this?
Well,
I don't know about you, but in my case, he had a mistress. You know, I think he knew that if we went to court, I'd get custody, and maybe he felt I would turn the boys against him or something. I really don't know. But things were not good between us, and he just disappeared. That's it. He just disappeared. When were you divorced?
We weren't.
I saw the papers.
Well, not with my signature, you didn't. As far as I'm concerned, we're still married. Oh, that son of a bitch.
You want to bring this person here into our house?
Just for dinner, honey. She stayed at the motel down at the Tully's.
Mother, why?
Because she's Robbie and Joey's mother, that's why.
I thought Carl said she was a drunk or something. Now you want to bring her into our home?
Well, Carl is a liar. Now get that through your head.
When does it stop, Mama? Can you tell me that? Why can't you just be normal for once in your life? Be my mother instead of everybody else's.
Now you can't talk to me like that.
You sound just like my mother.
This is where we all lived. The boys were happy here. Stop. It's my mother. Rayan, I know an investigator who can help us locate Carl.
Excuse me. I have homework.
She seems like a nice girl.
How can you tell?
She said, excuse me.
It's an old trick. You see, your husband lies to the court, Mrs. Gilvane, as to your whereabouts when he petitions them for a divorce. When the court tries to find you, they can't. They got the wrong address. You don't show up, the petition is granted, and bang, he's got his own uncontested divorce and sole custody. Somebody knows his way around the civil code.
So we're both married to him.
I'm afraid that's a horrible truth.
We just want to find him.
How? How do we find him?
Why don't you just leave the details to me and not worry yourself? I promise you, you will know everything you need to know.
What does that mean?
Well, let's just say things can get ugly.
This doesn't feel right. I'm putting a stop to this right now. I didn't like the sound of that at all.
Wheelwright, Holly Gibbons. Thank you very much for your time, but we've decided to do this on our own.
That's right.
Just send me a bill. Thanks.
We need to talk.
We'll do it on the way. She could be doing something illegal. No way.
Heaven forbid.
We're here. What are you going to tell them?
The truth.
What, that you and I are married to the same man? I don't think so.
Maybe not that part.
Maybe it'd be better if I just stayed out here.
Oh, no. Please, I'm not going in there alone.
Rayan, this is my family. Everybody, this is Rayan, Carl's first wife.
I thought you said she was dead.
Bobby?
Well, you did, didn't you?
Never mind what I said. That's my brother, Bobby, and my brother, Richard, and my mother, Louise Mitchell. May I have a word with you, please? Excuse me.
jaunt off and bring home an ex-wife.
She's Robbie and Joey's mother.
She is a stranger. You have a daughter, Holly. If you want to help someone, start there.
You do not have to tell me this.
Oh, yes, I do. When you haven't the sense the good Lord gave you.
Why are you yelling at me? I am not the one who left. I'm doing the best I can with a very difficult situation.
Shall we see how Amanda feels about that?
Holly, should we? I'm going to help this woman.
Help her do what? Work up a nice drunk?
She's not a drunk. You don't even know this person. I am going to help her find her kids, who she has not seen in 5 years.
Someone you know even less than you knew Carl.
Joey and Robbie are not strangers, Mama. I lived with them. I was their mother. You were their grandmother. If Carl had taken Amanda, wouldn't you want somebody to help us find her? I know I would. Fine. Doesn't matter. We'll manage just fine without your help. You'll see.
I'm not so sure.
Where's Rand?
She left.
What? Rand! Rand! Rand!
This isn't gonna work. I had my children taken away from me, and I don't like people telling me what to do.
Okay.
Make me crazy. I can't afford to be crazy again. I was once. That was enough. Look, we're different, Holly. Whatever gets the job done, I say yes, absolutely. There's no reward for being good, for doing the right thing. Go home. I can't help you, whatever it is you think you need to do.
Got a long way to walk.
Well, nobody's waiting up.
I was thinking, what about a newspaper ad?
No.
Why not? It's a great idea.
Newspaper's too local. Magazine's too expensive. He is gone.
No, I know a newspaper covers the entire South. Everybody reads it, and it costs peanuts for an ad. Ugh. Rand, I love your boys, and they love me right back. I was every bit the mother you would have been. Maybe we're not as different as you think. Come on. You said yourself there's nobody waiting up.
Speaking?
Yeah? Yes, yes, he wears glasses. Uh-huh. Where? Thank you very much.
Good.
We have a lead. You know us Mitchells, we don't sit around and wait for life to happen to us. We go up and stir it up.
You don't have to call Grandpa to me.
I'll call you.
You sure you want to do this?
Yeah, I'm sure.
About my first husband.
His name was Hayward. And when we were in high school and he was trying to pressure me into going all the way, I used to sing Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, you know, just to get my mind onto something else. You know, finally I couldn't hold out any longer, so we got married.
How old were you?
17.
17?
Mm. Mama married Daddy when she was 15, and that lasted 42 years.
Oh.
How old were you?
24. I even thought that was young.
24?
Well, St. Mary's School for Girls doesn't exactly prepare you for boys.
And I thought you northern girls grew up quick.
Not in Philadelphia. Well, not at St. Mary's anyway.
Hmm. Well, anyway, after we were married, me and Hayward spent 5 whole days in a hotel room. We've been going out since junior high. I mean, junior high, that's a long time for anybody to wait. If I only knew then what I know now.
Amen to that.
A virgin until you were 24?
Until Carl.
Willowgate Lane Farm. That's what Mr. Hubble said on the phone.
Welcome to the middle of nowhere.
What direction do you think we're going?
I don't know. I think west, I guess.
I thought the guy at the station said, take a left, go east to 168, but the even-numbered state roads go east-west, so how can you run into an east-west road if you're already heading west? We're lost.
I didn't know that about the roads.
Join the auto club.
I'm hungry.
We're not stopping until we find Willowgate Lane Farm.
We're here. This is it. Let's get out of here. There's no Morris Hubble anywhere, are you sure?
Thanks for checking.
There is no Morris Hubble anywhere. There's no Morris Hubble in this entire area.
It just doesn't make any sense.
There is no Good Samaritan.
What do you mean?
This is Carl written all over it. He saw that ad and he set us up.
Do you always have to be the cynical?
Well, about Carl? Yes, I do.
You know, it wouldn't hurt for you to be just a little less depressing.
Yes, it would. How far are you prepared to go?
Excuse me? All you said is that we had to look dignified.
I've done this before. It is no big deal. I'm just pretending to be my aunt.
Yeah, well, who am I supposed to be?
My uncle. I don't know. You're my assistant.
You know, I hate this. I really hate this. You should have told me what
your price tag still on your coat.
Thanks.
Miss Cathcart.
Thank you for seeing us.
The new moves list.
Yeah.
No one from Rose Hill, North Carolina. Sorry.
Can I see this?
Okay, listen, try something else. I want you to query all moves from North Carolina to South Carolina. Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Are you a little young to be in this position? Are you the manager?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I just expected somebody a little older. Washington keeps pretty close tabs on this particular job.
Oh, really?
Yeah, well, people move up out of this job, up the ladder pretty... It doesn't matter.
You know, that's exactly what I told my wife. I'll have to make a phone call.
Do what you have to do, but we really don't have very much time here. Please.
I'll need a signature at least.
It's no problem. Interstate fraud investigation, you can't be too careful. I appreciate that.
That was way too easy. You really have done that before, haven't you?
You have no idea the things I've done. Not here.
So, Carl set us up once again. Is he really that...
Underhanded. How'd you kill me?
I, I just don't know people like that. You don't know people like this.
You married one. You're not harboring some idea this man's coming back to you, are you?
No.
I can't believe you'd be that naive.
But I am not that naive.
He never loved you. He is incapable of it. Let's go home.
Trust a person who can't get mad. That's what my daddy always said.
What are you talking about? I've been mad at you ever since I met you.
No, you haven't. You've been cynical. There's a difference. Can you hear me that?
Getting mad is easy. Living with it is the hard part, because you wouldn't know a thing about that living up on Walton's Mountain. This is gonna kill me. Just as well as you.
See what I'm talking about?
Eat a cockroach.
You are the most ungrateful woman I have ever met.
Well, at least I don't go around making an ass out of myself trying to be my kid's best friend.
Oh, please, you should talk. At least I didn't lose my kids. Excuse me, do you have a ladies' room?
In the back.
Thanks.
Keep walking. You fight dirty.
Comes from having brothers. You're pretty tough yourself. Listen, Rayanne. I didn't mean what I said about the boys. It was an evil thing to say. Evil and untrue, and I'm sorry.
Yeah. I've heard worse. You forget I used to live with Carl. I didn't mean what I said either.
Yeah, you did. And you're right. I have a lot to learn about being a mother. Hell, I got a lot to learn about being a grown-up, but don't tell anybody I said that.
You know, Amanda is a wonderful kid. You gotta be doing something, right?
Go figure. Well, she is what she is in spite of everything. That's the remarkable part. She's not gonna make the same mistakes I did either, I know that. It's just that, you know, every kid deserves a childhood, and Amanda's had precious little of that.
It's the 90s, Holly. Kids grow up fast, faster than you think. Hey. I'm not the one you should be telling all this to.
Oh, no. Amanda's not going to want to talk to me on the phone. Hi, Mom, it's me. Yeah, we're in South Carolina. Is Amanda around? What? When? Oh, my God, we're on our way. Amanda's run away.
Going to drop you off. You don't have to do that.
Rain, I don't know how long I'm going to be. I don't even know where I'm going or where I'm going to start.
It's okay. I'm good at this.
I've never been on her own before.
You said yourself she's a smart girl.
She could be sick. She could be in an accident somewhere. Who knows?
Holly, she's going to be okay.
How do you know that? How do you know that? She is 13 years old. Anything could happen to her. She's a child. She needs a parent.
Oh, honey, thank God you're here. Did you know he was gone?
Yeah.
You knew?
Your letter started coming back months ago. I didn't tell you because I didn't want to hurt you.
You know, you expect me to be adult about everything. But you can't even be straight with me about the one thing that really means anything to me.
You can't even tell me my own father's left. I can't tell you how that sucks. You know, you chased after Joey and Robbie's father with a stranger. And you can't even tell me about my own father.
You're right, okay? You're right. I'm a horrible mother. I've made every mistake a mother can possibly make, and I've made your life miserable. I will cop to that. But I am not the one who made your father go away. That is the one thing I will not take the blame for. He did that all by himself. He got up and left us. And the sooner you accept that, honey, the easier your life is gonna be. Oh, I'm so sorry.
I don't want to die in Bug Tussle, North Carolina, okay? Just slow down. Maybe I should drive.
No!
Are you sure?
I am sure. Look, I just can't stand woman drivers.
You're completely scary sometimes.
I know. Sometimes I scare myself. You know what the worst part is? The worst part is Carl's gonna turn those little boys into versions of himself, and they're never gonna know what it's like to have a real family. It's my fault.
Look, you choose the wrong guys. That's all you've done. And you too, you know, you have each other. And that's a lot. Matter of fact, that's just about everything.
I'll take care of it.
I'm doing it wrong, huh?
Grandma says we're gonna have to move.
Well, Grandma shouldn't be scaring you like that.
So are we moving again or what?
Maybe we will, maybe we won't. We'll see. But it's not your job to worry about it.
Somebody has to.
Yes, but not you.
Good night.
Good night, honey.
You like her, don't you?
Yes.
Me too. Maybe it's not so bad if you help her.
Sweet dreams.
I had a breakdown a couple years ago. I was in a hospital. That's why I was afraid to come here. I wasn't sure if I was strong enough to do this anymore. But nothing's gonna stop me. Not now.
But that's what I'm telling you. I am his wife. He abandons one of your stores, up and leaves without an explanation, and you refuse to give me any information? What kind of sense does that make?
Company policy?
You want company policy? Here's your company policy. Idiot. Whatever happened to fair play and doing the right thing?
You're it. Believe me, I've looked.
Now, there's a frightening thought. Me as a role model. I was thinking.
Not out.
What you said about Miss Wheelwright.
And?
Well, maybe we should pay her another visit just to hear what she has to say and then decide. So, you can do this, whatever it is, without getting into trouble.
Ladies, there are things you need to know and things you don't. It's in my job description to know the difference.
What do you think?
You know what I think.
Do it.
Makes sense. I have the room. Don't give me that look. There's independent and there's foolish.
Oh, is that what you two talk about? My foolishness?
That and other things.
She's had a life, your friend, right out of the book of Job.
This way. I don't want to smell those pigs. I don't know how Bobby stands it.
We're not moving in with you, Mama.
Pigs are not the future of this state. We are tobacco farmers.
Did you hear me?
I bet we are, would.
Talking to you is like talking to a brick wall.
Lucky for you, I was a brick wall.
That's what I always used to say to Daddy.
You were his favorite.
No, Bobby was.
You were the one he doted on.
I was his only daughter. I reminded him of you.
We are family. And if you cannot accept my help as it's offered under my roof, then you cannot look to me. It's not fair.
Like I told you, my husband and I have not received the duplicate copies I asked for. I've given you our new address 3 times. His name's Carl Gibbons. Can you confirm that for me? 326 Primrose, Clifton, West Virginia. That's it. Yeah, I'll be expecting it. Thank you. Rayanne! I found him! So, since Carl and Rayanne are not legally divorced, he can't possibly have legal custody of the kids, can he?
Go on.
So when the children go with her, she is simply performing her God-given duties as a mother.
Go with her?
Of their own accord.
She needs the appropriate paperwork.
Paperwork? Please, this man has abandoned 2 wives, stolen the kids, taken them across state lines. What kind of law requires a mother to get paperwork?
Our kind.
This paperwork is almost 5 years old. What took you so long?
I just found out about it. I was never contacted.
Pursuant to State versus Carl Gibbons, a.k.a. Carl Gilbane, in the petition to vacate decree of divorce, granted. See the clerk for the paperwork.
This way, ladies.
Next.
Oh, my God, it's so easy. No wonder you use the court system.
Thank you.
Good luck. Good.
Okay.
Be careful.
Here you go.
Thanks. Thank you, Mike.
Okay.
Let's go. I wonder if she'll ever find peace.
Since I felt like
Like what?
I don't know.
Like part of a family? Well, to me it's more like a life sentence than a family, you know, like you have been sentenced to life with the Mitchells. I think most people would prefer a quick and painless execution.
I don't think so.
Wait, what are you going to do, pull him out of the car? Just wait. Come on. What's the truck?
I got him.
Don't lose them.
Don't worry. Okay, just give me 2 minutes. You all right?
Holly?
Hello, you guys. Oh, Ethan.
How did you find us? Daddy said you hated us.
Oh, that's not true. That's not true at all. Hi, I'm Holly.
Sheila, how do you know the boys?
Well, we all stayed together for a while, not too long ago. Is your daddy coming?
Yes.
Good. It'll be good to see him. Guys, I have someone with me who wants to see you. Now, I know that this is going to come as a very big surprise, and it's different than anything your daddy's ever told you. This person who wants to see you is your mother.
Excuse me?
Jeremy?
Ronald. Look at you. I know this is awful sudden, and it's probably very confusing, but I missed you so much.
It's okay, Jerry.
I think maybe you better leave.
Oh, we're not going anywhere.
Jeremy, it's me, honey. It's Mommy. Do you remember when we bought the rabbit for Ronald? Remember there was this little lady and she was on the street and she had all these little...
Boys, do you know this woman? No. I've never seen her before.
Honey, you were so young.
Her mother is dead. I think you better call the police.
Yeah, I think that'd be a very good idea.
Look, I don't know you people and I am asking you to leave now. Please. I'm being nice. Our mother is dead.
No. Your father took you away from her.
Thank God, Carl.
Here we go.
some takeout boxes, please. Come on, take the boys to the car. Come on, boys, let's go. In the car.
These are my children, too.
Let's go. Outside. Not anymore. They're not. You have no right here. No.
You're wrong, Carl.
No, I'm not. I was right about you, too, wasn't I? You forced me and the boys out of your life. Of course, you knew that.
What are you talking about?
You put your nose where it didn't belong. You could have been their mother. You could have had a wonderful life. It was all there for you to have. But now you had to go and screw it all up. Could you take a look at this, please?
I have papers here.
Yeah, well, so do I.
This isn't going to work.
Look, these women have been harassing me and my
family.
This isn't
going to work this time.
Man, this paperwork is all well and good, but I'm afraid it's not enough.
What?
Why?
He has a sole custody decree for the two boys.
No, they're not even divorced. Take a look.
I understand, but your writ here is North Carolina. Here's a West Virginia. And this is West Virginia.
Officer, I mean, do my boys look like they'd rather be with this woman?
Oh, you bastard.
I mean, listen to her. Listen.
I'm sorry.
Do you mind if I take my sons home now?
No. No.
I'll meet
you. This is a mistake. You can't let him get
these women are following me.
This is not over, Carl. It is not over. Let go of me.
Buckle up, guys.
Oh, no.
It's in the truck.
Dad, I don't want to move again.
Look, just leave it to me. Everything is under control. Now, I'll be back at lunchtime, so you guys be ready, okay?
That was our mom, wasn't it?
No. Your mother is dead, like I told you. Now, go on. Go.
It's all coming apart. You have to tell me what to do.
Well, we have to get him on something else. They got Capone on tax evasion, right?
Something we haven't thought of.
Well, what? Tell me what?
You stay put. I'm calling Gerard. I'll call you right back.
All right. Mike? Oh, hi, Gerard.
Here, no, it's here. Turn here, left.
They're gone.
Carl wins again, and again, and again, and again.
Rayanne, you can't give up. These are your kids. Now, come on, we just have to think, okay? Let's think. Private school.
Yeah!
You okay?
Yeah.
You sure?
He's gonna flip out if he finds you.
Oh, my God. Are you okay?
Yeah, we're moving again.
Don't you worry about that. Is your brother here?
I don't know.
Rayanne, I swear. Look at you. What are you on, drugs?
Don't you tell me I don't have any rights to our children. I'm their mother. I have just as many rights as you do. Listen to me. I'm not the one who denied them a mother for 5 years. I am not the one who kidnapped them.
Could you just calm down? Our children
What's
go to school.
What's the matter, Carl? Are you afraid I might actually be hurt?
Mr. Evans? Headmaster Thompson, would you please summon the police? This woman is trying to kidnap my children.
That is not true.
You want a police officer, Carl? There's two of them right back there.
What? Boys? Boys, come on. Let's go to the car.
You said Mommy is dead.
As far as we're concerned, she is. Come on, let's go.
And it's time to face the real world,
Carl. Just get out of my way. Get out of my way.
Excuse me, sir. Are you Carl Gibbons?
Yes, I am, and I'd like to lodge a complaint.
I'm going to ask you to step over to the car, if you would.
Me? No, you don't understand. She's the one you want.
No, sir. You are.
What?
I have a warrant for your arrest.
Arrest? What are you talking
about?
Sir,
I'm going to read you your rights and put you in handcuffs. Do you understand
what
I'm saying?
Some paperwork right here. A warrant for what? I haven't done anything wrong.
You're being arrested for suspicion of bigotry.
What?
It's Class H felony. You're going to jail. Now, come on.
You have made the biggest mistake of your life.
A lie.
Honey,
I lied about everything, didn't
I? Oh, you know what? Your father loves you very much.
And that's something that's never been a lie, ever.
Excuse me. I don't know you people.
It's okay. She's our mother. We both are.
Amanda? You okay?
So where are you off to next?
I'm not going anywhere. I'm all yours. Come here, sit down. Do you know that if anything ever happened to you, I would never get over it?
You like making my life miserable, don't you?
I wouldn't have it any other way. You two are missing the cake. Why don't you go on down? I'll meet you there, okay?
I know you're not moving in.
I'm sorry, Mama.
I don't need all those coming and goings anyway. What I do need is to start to enjoy myself more, which is a very difficult thing to do with a house full of women. Your father'd be proud of you.
What about you, Mama?
I'm not sure I know you anymore. Yes, I'm proud of you.
Of course it is.
Ronald asked me if he was ever going to see his father again.
What did you say?
Well, I said yes. After a while. You know, I'm not going to do to those boys what Carl did. That's for sure. Oh, I have to get to know my own children all over again. This is so strange.
It's going to be okay. You are a great mom.
Goodbye, guys. I am really going to miss you.
Your mom. Okay. This is just what I need, one more person to break my heart.
You think you're gonna get rid of me that easy? Come on. Okay.
There's a new wrinkle in the linen.
Excuse me?
Ma'am, matrimonial work is my stock and trade, my specialty, if you will. And when a wife tells me that she doesn't think her husband has really run off on her, when all of the evidence points to the contrary, it just runs against everything I know to be true.
Unless, of course, he's not really gone for good. There's always that possibility.
You one of the Mitchells farms tobacco up on Parson Weems Road?
Yes, Bobby's my brother.
You people as rich as everybody says you are?
No, but you'll get paid if that's what you're asking.
I got cherry and grape.
What about the orange?
I ate them.
No, thanks.
Let me take a stab here. You previously married?
Yes. She's dead.
Any bad blood in his past? You know, angry husband, irate business partner, things of that nature might have spooked him off.
That's why I'm here, Miss Wilwright. For you to find out. Gerard said you were good.
I'm better than good. But it's nice he says so. What's her name?
Who?
The dead wife.
Rayanne. Why?
Well, you gotta start someplace. That is, if we're in business.
We are, if you can assure me. Would be absolutely discreet. You see, my family has lived here for a very long time.
Now that, Mrs. Gibbons, sounds a lot more like it. I am the picture of discretion, I assure you. You just ask anyone.
Hi, honey.
Grandma's here.
How did you find out? The realty office called me. We have an interest in Carl's building.
I just didn't want to worry you. I was going to tell you as soon as I knew for sure.
Really? Yes. I would have guessed that you'd know the signs by now.
What signs?
The signs of departure. But then, I should have known better myself. Who gives someone a watch the first time he meets you?
I didn't see you giving it back, Mama.
You don't see me wearing it either, do you? Give it back. Honestly, Holly. Is that how you were brought up? Where have you been all this time anyway? Out. Think about what we talked about.
What did you and Grandma talk about?
Nothing.
Amanda.
She thinks that we should consider living with her.
And what did you say?
I didn't know what to
say. Well, next time she asks you, you tell her it's none of her business. You got that?
Your husband changed his name. It's not Gibbons. It's Gilbane, the kids too. Ronald and Jeremy. Robbie and Joey aren't their real names.
Can I see that?
Sure.
Are you sure about this?
It's right there in black and white. Your husband's first wife was Rayanne Gilbane, born Rayanne Wicks, of Philadelphia.
Pennsylvania.
Last time I checked. There are no tax filings for any of them in Connecticut. So no driver's license, traffic tickets, voter registration, etc., etc. They never lived there, is my guess. But that's not the big news. She's not dead. She's his ex. The divorce decree.
She's alive?
If you call working for the auto club alive, yeah, she's alive. I'm sorry to say, Mrs. Gibbons, but it seems your husband has not been fully honest with you. Can I get you something? A little water?
What about the boys?
He got sole custody 5 years ago.
What kind of woman would give up her kids?
Well, she must be something, all right. Although he's not exactly the soup du jour either.
Did you say 5 years?
Yeah, 5 years. Why?
Did you get a phone number?
No, that's gonna take some time.
Wait, not for him. Is this Rayanne Gilbane?
Speaking.
Were you once married to a Carl Gilbane?
Who is this? Who is this?
I know Carl. Is there somewhere we can meet? Oh, thank you, honey. My favorite.
Do I get to have an opinion about this?
Of course you do, honey. What kind of question is that?
This is beginning to scare me. I mean, lying to Grandma is one thing. But going off?
24 hours, that's all.
Men leave, Mama. Why can't you just accept that?
Honey, please.
He doesn't love us. And now you're driving off to New Jersey?
Amanda, listen to me. I'm not leaving you. You are stuck with me. I'm going to be in your face when you're 105, making your life a living misery. But I have to do this. Can you understand that? 24 hours, that's it.
What do you know about my boys?
They're good kids. And Carl has told them that you're dead.
And they believe this?
Yes.
Who are you? What do you want?
I want the truth.
About what?
About Carl.
You call me in the middle of the night? You show up here like a private detective to ask me questions about Carl? Do you have a name?
Holly.
And I am supposed to, what, to tell you what a great guy Carl is?
I expected you to be angry.
Oh, I'm not angry. No, I could be if I wanted to, but I try to keep that at a minimum. No, I am in the each day is a new day stage. Perhaps you've heard of it.
Maybe this was not a very good idea. I think I made a mistake.
Sit down. I'll tell you whatever you want. Truth, however, is rather overrated.
Not with me, is it?
Fine, I'll play.
Carl said some things.
I'll bet.
That you drank.
My last drink was in college. It was a gin and tonic. I liked it. It didn't like me. I have an enzyme imbalance in my blood.
Really?
Not much fun, this truth thing, huh? He will hurt you like you've never been hurt before, and then he will carry on as if you never even existed. That's the truth. Holly, you're the first lead I've had in 2 years. I haven't seen Ronald or Jeremy since Carl stole them.
Stole them?
Kidnapped, if you prefer.
When?
5 birthdays ago. 5 Christmases. 5 first days of school. My turn. Where are they?
I don't know.
Are you going to help me?
What do you mean?
Well, what do you think I mean?
No, look,
I answered your questions.
I'm sorry, I can't do this.
I'm sorry.
Please don't. Can't.
Hey. Hey, I'm not the one to be afraid of. You know, you say you want the truth, and then when the shoe's on the other foot, then you just run away. Think about that. It's no wonder your life is in such a mess. I'm not the one to run from here.
Why does he do this?
Well, I don't know about you, but in my case, he had a mistress. You know, I think he knew that if we went to court, I'd get custody, and maybe he felt I would turn the boys against him or something. I really don't know. But things were not good between us, and he just disappeared.
That's it. He just disappeared. When were you divorced?
We weren't.
I saw the papers.
Well, not with my signature, you didn't. As far as I'm concerned, we're still married. Oh, that son of a bitch.
You want to bring this person here into our house?
Just for dinner, honey. She stayed at the motel down at the Tully's.
Mother, why?
Because she's Robbie and Joey's mother, that's why.
I thought Carl said she was a drunk or something. Now you want to bring her into our home?
Well, Carl is a liar. Now get that through your head.
When does it stop, Mama? Can you tell me that? Why can't you just be normal for once in your life? Be my mother instead of everybody else's.
Now you can't talk to me like that.
You sound just like my mother.
This is where we all lived. The boys were happy here. Stop. It's my mother. Rayan, I know an investigator who can help us locate Carl.
Excuse me. I have homework.
She seems like a nice girl.
How can you tell?
She said, excuse me.
It's an old trick. You see, your husband lies to the court, Mrs. Gilvane, as to your whereabouts when he petitions them for a divorce. When the court tries to find you, they can't. They got the wrong address. You don't show up, the petition is granted, and bang, he's got his own uncontested divorce and sole custody. Somebody knows his way around the civil code.
So we're both married to him.
I'm afraid that's a horrible truth.
We just want to find him.
How do we find him?
Why don't you just leave the details to me and not worry yourself? I promise you, you will know everything you need to know.
What does that mean?
Well, let's just say things can get ugly.
This doesn't feel right. I'm putting a stop to this right now. I didn't like the sound of that at all.
Holly Gibbons. Thank you very much for your time, but we've decided to do this on our own. That's right. Just send me a bill. Thanks.
We need to talk.
We'll do it on the way. She could be doing something illegal. No way.
Heaven forbid.
We're here. What are you going to tell them?
The truth.
What, that you and I are married to the same man? I don't think so.
Maybe not that part.
Maybe it'd be better if I just stayed out here.
Oh, no. Please, I'm not going in there alone. Rayanne, this is my family. Everybody, this is Rayanne, Carl's first wife.
I thought you said she was dead.
Bobby?
Well, you did, didn't you?
Never mind what I said. That's my brother Bobby, and my brother Richard, and my mother Louise Mitchell. May I have a word with you, please? Excuse me.
Off and bring home an ex-wife.
She's Robbie and Joey's mother.
She is a stranger. You have a daughter, Holly. If you want to help someone, start there.
You do not have to tell me this.
Oh, yes, I do. When you haven't the sense the good Lord gave you.
Why are you yelling at me? I am not the one who left. I'm doing the best I can. I'm so sorry.
North Carolina, okay? Just slow down. Maybe I should drive.
No!
Are you sure?
I am sure. Look, I just can't stand woman drivers.
You're completely scary sometimes.
I know. Sometimes I scare myself. You know what the worst part is? The worst part is Carl's gonna turn those little boys into versions of himself, and they're never gonna know what it's like to have a real family. That's my fault.
Look, you choose the wrong guys. That's all you've done. And you too, you know, you have each other. And that's a lot. Matter of fact, that's just about everything.
I'll take care of it.
I'm doing it wrong, huh?
Grandma says we're gonna have to move.
Well, Grandma shouldn't be scaring you like that.
So are we moving again or what?
Maybe we will, maybe we won't. We'll see. But it's not your job to worry about it.
Somebody has to.
Yes, but not you.
Good night.
Good night, honey.
You like her, don't you?
Yes.
Me too. Maybe it's not so bad if you help her.
Sweet dreams.
I had a breakdown a couple years ago. I was in a hospital. That's why I was afraid to come here. I wasn't sure if I was strong enough to do this anymore. But nothing's gonna stop me. Not now.
But that's what I'm telling you. I am his wife. He abandons one of your stores, up and leaves without an explanation, and you refuse to give me any information? What kind of sense does that make? Company policy? You want company policy? Here's your company policy. Idiot. Whatever happened to fair play and doing the right thing?
You're it. Believe me, I've looked.
Now, there's a frightening thought. Me as a role model.
I was thinking.
Not out.
What you said about Miss Wheelwright.
And?
Well, maybe we should pay her another visit just to hear what she has to say and then decide. So, you can do this, whatever it is, without getting into trouble.
Ladies, there are things you need to know and things you don't. It's in my job description to know the difference.
What do you think?
You know what I think.
Do it.
Oh, you want us all to move in together?
Makes sense. I have the room. Don't give me that look. There's independent and there's foolish.
Oh, is that what you two talk about? My foolishness?
That and other things.
She's had a life, your friend, right out of the book of Job.
This way. I don't want to smell those pigs. I don't know how Bobby stands it.
We're not moving in with you, Mama.
Pigs are not the future of this state. We are tobacco farmers.
Did you hear me?
I bet we are, Wood.
Talking to you is like talking to a brick wall.
Lucky for you, I was a brick wall.
That's what I always used to say to Daddy.
You were his favorite.
No, Bobby was.
You were the one he doted on.
I was his only daughter. I reminded him of you.
We are family. And if you cannot accept my help as it's offered under my roof, then you cannot look to me. It's not fair.
Like I told you, my husband and I have not received the duplicate copies I asked for. I've given you our new address 3 times. His name's Carl Gibbons. Can you confirm that for me? 326 Primrose, Clifton, West Virginia. That's it. Yeah, I'll be expecting it. Thank you. Rayanne! I found them! So, since Carl and Rayanne are not legally divorced, he can't possibly have legal custody of the kids, can he?
Go on.
So when the children go with her, she is simply performing her God-given duties as a mother.
Go with her?
Of their own accord.
She needs the appropriate paperwork.
Paperwork? Please, this man has abandoned 2 wives, stolen the kids, taken them across state lines. What kind of law requires a mother to get paperwork?
Our kind.
This paperwork is almost 5 years old. What took you so long?
I just found out about it. I was never contacted.
Pursuant to State versus Carl Gibbons, a.k.a. Carl Gil Bain, in the petition to vacate decree of divorce. Granted. See the clerk for the paperwork.
This way, ladies.
Next.
Oh, my God. It's so easy. No wonder you use the court system. Thank you.
Good luck.
Okay.
Be careful.
Here you go.
Thank you, Mike.
Okay,
let's go.
I wonder if she'll ever find peace.
It's been a long time since I felt like this.
Like what?
I don't know.
Like part of a family? To me, it's more like a life sentence than a family, you know, like you have been sentenced to life with the Mitchells. I think most people would prefer a quick and painless execution.
I don't think so.
Wait, what are you going to do, pull him out of the car? Just wait. Come on.
What's the truck?
I got him.
Don't lose them.
Don't worry. Okay, just give me 2 minutes. You all right?
Holly?
Hello, you guys. Always.
How did you find
you?
Daddy said you hated us.
Oh, that's not true. That's not true at all. Hi, I'm Holly.
Sheila, how do you know the boys?
Well, we all stayed together for a while, not too long ago. Is your daddy coming?
Yes.
Good. It'll be good to see him. Guys, I have someone with me who wants to see you. Now, I know that this is going to come as a very big surprise, and it's different than anything your daddy's ever told you. This person who wants to see you is your mother.
Excuse me?
Jeremy? Ronald. Look at you. I know this is awful sudden, and it's probably very confusing, but I missed you so much.
It's okay, Joey.
I think maybe you better leave.
Oh, we're not going anywhere.
Jeremy, it's me, honey. It's Mommy. Do you remember when we bought the rabbit for Ronald? Remember there was this little old lady and she was on the street and she had all these little...
Do you know this woman?
No. I've never seen him before.
Honey, you were so young.
Your mother is dead. I think you better call the police.
Yeah, I think that'd be a very good idea.
Look, I don't know you people, and I am asking you to leave now. Please. I'm being nice. Our mother is dead.
No. Your father took you away from her.
Thank God, Carl.
Here we go.
Some takeout boxes, please. Come on, take the boys to the car. Come on, boys, let's go.
No,
in the car.
These are my children, too.
Let's go. Outside. Not anymore, they're not. You have no right here.
No.
You're wrong, Carl.
I warn you not. I was right about you, too, wasn't I? You forced me and the boys out of your life. Of course, you knew that.
What are you talking about?
You put your nose where it didn't belong. You could have been their mother. You could have had a wonderful life. It was all there for you to have. And now you had to go and screw it all up. Could you take a look at this, please?
I have papers here.
Yeah, well, so do I.
This isn't going to work.
Look, these women have been harassing me and my family.
This isn't going to work this time. Brad? What do you know about my boys? Please, I have a custody decree here, a court order. It's all legal. You want to see the papers?
No. Why don't we find someplace? Jeremy is into soccer. He wears his uniform everywhere. And Ronald keeps losing his new glasses because he thinks they make him look dorky, which they don't. And they're good kids. And Carl has told them that you're dead. And they believe this?
Yes.
Who are you? What do you want?
I want the truth.
Okay. Say goodbye to the house.
Is that supposed to make me feel better? The first day of the rest of our lives.
Mom, what we're homeless.
It'll be okay, honey.
You'll see.
I'm sorry, honey. I really thought that I could make it work on our own.
Well, we made it for 6 months without Dad's help. That's pretty good.
Yeah, good old Haywood.
Living with Grandma might be fun.
Oh, it's not exactly my idea of happily ever after.
What did you tell her?
As little as possible. When we get there, I'll sit her down one-on-one and make it clear that this is only temporary until we get back on our feet.
She'll want to know more than that.
Yeah.
Can you believe this?
Oh, Holly.
Yeah.
Hey, Holly.
Hi.
How
Look what the cat dragged in.
Well, she told me, Mama.
What are you talking about? We're family.
Oh, honey.
Hi.
Honey. Hey. Goodness.
Molly, get rid of her. Come on. Come on.
Good to see you too, Bobby.
Oh, my.
You're getting tall. You're getting as tall as I am.
It's a party.
Yeah, it's a party. Look how tall you got. You're still short, though.
Come on, I gotta get you some food.
Morning.
When are we going to tell Dad where we are?
Anytime you want. You know where he is. You know, I envy you. I love junior high school.
Yeah, well, you can take my place.
I bet I could. I've still got the legs.
Go ahead.
Oh, come on, don't be like that. This is hard for me, too, you know. At least you know where you're going to school. I still have to find myself a job.
Yeah, well, I liked my school.
Yeah, well, I liked my home, too, but I'm not the reason we had to leave.
Yeah, well, you're the one who pushed for the divorce.
Excuse me? Fine. But if that's the way it is, at least get your facts straight. He is the one who left. I am the one who stayed.
There she is again. You say her name is Holly?
Holly. Holly Mitchell.
She just moved back to town. Works as a private nurse.
Hey, can you give me a hand here, please?
I'd be happy to. Here, let me get that for you. It smells good. What are you, feeding an army?
Something like that. Don't bother, I got it. Okay.
My name's Carl Gibbons. Those are my boys over there, Joey and Robbie. We're new in town.
Holly Mitchell, thank you.
I know. I was wondering if maybe we could get together sometime. But my realtor told me that your family knows everybody in the area, and since I'm opening a new business, Hey, Joey, get your brother down from there. Robbie, get down, please. Thank you. Kids.
Well, thank you very much, but...
How about if I said strictly business?
Really? No, thanks.
Well, it's okay. It's okay. I've heard no before. But you're making a mistake.
What kind of business are you starting here?
It's going to be a general store, modern, but a little old-fashioned, kind of like me.
You know, I have brothers.
You want me to ask one of them out?
Sure. 555-0062. Good luck.
0062. Okay.
Really? I'll remember that.
I'm 13. You can talk to me.
I do, honey, all the time.
Not on an interpersonal level, you don't.
What, have you been reading Cosmo?
Well, it's true.
Nothing happened on any level, and you shouldn't believe everything you read.
Thank you.
Don't tell you cooked this whole dinner yourself.
Just calm down. Yes, I did.
You did? Well, I think the chicken's getting cold.
What do you want me to eat it up?
Not while I'm sitting on the end. My.
Oh, thank you.
Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you.
At least this one cleans up good.
Stop it, Richard.
Observation, nothing more.
Is that for me? Thank you.
Oh, that is beautiful. Thank you very much, Robbie.
Thank you very much. All right.
Get out of here! Get out of here!
I insisted. I don't want to worry.
Don't worry. Look, my family is suspicious of my taste in men. I've told you my first husband was no prize, and that's putting it kindly, so just give them time.
Oh, I did. I gave them watches. I just want them to like me.
They will.
What about you? What about you? No, I don't want to have my picture.
No, you should be in this.
I hate to have my picture.
Why?
I take a lousy picture. Come on.
How could you?
It's much prettier with you in it. Please. Here. Wait, here. Scissors.
Okay, everybody get together.
Scissors for the ribbon. Okay,
everybody together.
Ready? Joey, Robbie, get together.
On three.
All righty, let's go. One, two, three. Here we go. Perfect. Great.
I think I closed my eyes, Dad.
You want to do it one more time?
Yeah.
Okay. Go. Come on, Holly, let's not spoil our day.
It won't spoil our day.
Yes, it will.
What are you afraid of?
I'm not afraid of anything.
Then why won't you tell me about her?
Okay. It was a perfect marriage. I worked, she drank, we never saw each other.
Don't tell me, forget it.
Oh, come on, honey, we were miserable.
Forget it.
Well, she got very ill. You know what it's like when they tell you? I mean, the worse the news is, the smaller the sentence they use. And when the news is really, really bad, they just use one word. Inoperable.
Are you saying she died?
No.
Carl, why didn't you tell me?
Well, it's not something I've had a lot of practice at, Holly. I mean, there was Rayanne, and now there's you. It's a hard thing to bring up at the beginning of a relationship.
So what was it?
Well, it's just a tiny speck on a CAT scan. Anyway, afterwards, I just felt like the boys needed a fresh start, you know. A place without memories, a place where the sun shines. And the company said Rose Hill, and I said yes. I mean, based on the name alone. Our marriage was over long before she got sick.
I'm sorry. I'm glad you told me.
Me too.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Are you glad?
Mitchell, I'll never hurt your daughter. I'll be there for her and Amanda in every way they need. I love her deeply. I'm asking for your daughter's hand.
Can you help me with this place?
Another one?
All those are really pretty. Thank you.
Oh, my gosh. Let's get an old, something new, something borrow, something blue. I don't have something blue.
You can have my blue bunny.
You'd let me borrow that?
Yeah. It's in the car.
Why don't you go get that for me, okay?
Wait. First, you have to come here and give me a big hug. Come on.
Now, why don't you go get me that blue bunny, okay? All right, hurry up. Don't get lost.
Holly.
Hi, Joey. What is it? What's wrong?
I don't like this.
Why not? That's a great suit. You look very handsome in it.
I don't like it.
All right, then why don't you come in here, sit down, and we'll talk about it. So, if it's not this suit, then what?
Well, Dad said no, and he says no.
Well, right now you're talking to me, so why don't you ask me?
With tenderness, with care, with love and understanding. The relationship that you will begin with these vows shall grow in beauty and in truth because you have nurtured them. And now, in the eyes of God and the state of North Carolina, I now pronounce you man and wife.
Can with a very difficult situation.
Shall we see how Amanda feels about that?
Holly, I'm going to help this woman.
Help her do what? Work up a nice drunk?
She's not a drunk. You don't even know this person. I'm going to help her find her kids, who she has not seen in 5 years.
Someone you know even less than you knew Carl.
Joey and Robbie are not strangers, Mama. I lived with them. I was their mother. You were their grandmother. If Carl had taken Amanda, wouldn't you want somebody to help us find her? I know I would. Fine. Doesn't matter. We'll manage just fine without your help. You'll see.
I'm not so sure.
Where's Rand?
She left.
What?
Children taken away from me, and I don't like people telling me what to do.
Okay.
Make me crazy. I can't afford to be crazy again. I was once. That was enough. Look, we're different, Holly. Whatever gets the job done, I say yes, absolutely. There's no reward for being good, for doing the right thing. Go home. I can't help you, whatever it is you think you need to do.
Got a long way to walk.
Nobody's waiting up.
I was thinking, what about a newspaper ad?
No.
Why not? It's a great idea.
Newspaper's too local. Magazine's too expensive. He is gone.
No, I know a newspaper covers the entire South. Everybody reads it, and it costs peanuts for an ad. Oh. Rand, I loved your boys, and they loved me right back. I was every bit the mother you would have been. Maybe we're not as different as you think. Come on. You said yourself there's nobody waiting up.
Speaking?
Yeah?
Yes, yes, he wears glasses. Uh-huh. Where? Thank you very much.
Good.
We have a lead. I'm just going to be a day or two.
Okay?
Okay.
Come on.
You know us Mitchells. We don't sit around and wait for life to happen to us. We go up and
stir it up.
You don't have to quote Grandpa to me.
I'll call you.
You sure you want to do this?
Yeah, I'm sure.
About my first husband.
His name was Hayward. And when we were in high school and he was trying to pressure me into going all the way, I used to sing Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, you know, just to get my mind onto something else. You know, finally I couldn't hold out any longer, so we got married.
How old were you?
17.
17?
Hmm. Mama married Daddy when she was 15, and that lasted 42 years.
Oh.
How old were you?
24. I even thought that was young.
24?
Well, St. Mary's School for Girls doesn't exactly prepare you for boys.
And I thought you northern girls grew up quick.
Not in Philadelphia. Well, not at St. Mary's anyway.
Hmm. Well, anyway, after we were married, me and Hayward spent 5 whole days in a hotel room. We've been going out since junior high. I mean, junior high, that's a long time for anybody to wait. If I only knew then what I know now. Hmm.
Amen to that.
A virgin until you were 24?
Until Carl.
Willowgate Lane Farm. That's what Mr. Hubble said on the phone. Welcome to the middle of nowhere.
What direction do you think we're going?
I don't know. I think west, I guess.
I thought the guy at the station said, take a left, go east to 168, but the even-numbered state roads go east-west, so how can you run into an east-west road if you're already heading west? We're lost.
I didn't know that about the roads.
Join the auto club.
I'm hungry.
We're not stopping until we find Willowgate Lane Farm.
We're here. This is it. Let's get out of here.
There's no Morris Hubble anywhere, are you sure? Thanks for checking. There is no Morris Hubble anywhere. There's no Morris Hubble in this entire area. This doesn't make any sense.
There is no Good Samaritan.
What do you mean?
This is Carl written all over it. He saw that ad and he set us up.
Do you always have to be the cynical?
Well, about Carl? Yes, I do.
You know, it wouldn't hurt for you to be just a little less depressing.
Yes, it would. How far are you prepared to go?
said is that we had to look dignified.
I've done this before. It is no big deal. I'm just pretending to be my aunt.
Yeah, well, who am I supposed to be?
My uncle. I don't know. You're my assistant.
You know, I hate this. I really hate this. You should have told me what
your price tag still on your coat.
Thanks.
Miss Cathcart.
Thank you for seeing us.
The new moves list.
Yeah.
No one from Rose Hill, North Carolina. Sorry.
Can I see this?
Okay, listen, try something else. I want you to query all moves from North Carolina to South Carolina. Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Are you a little young to be in this position? Are you the manager?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I just expected somebody a little older. Washington keeps pretty close tabs on this particular job.
Oh, really?
Yeah, well, people move up out of this job, up the ladder pretty good. It doesn't matter.
You know, that's exactly what I told my wife. I'll have to make a phone call.
Do what you have to do, but we really don't have very much time here. Please.
I'll need a signature at least.
It's no problem. Interstate fraud investigation, you can't be too careful. I appreciate that.
That was way too easy. You really have done that before, haven't you?
You have no idea the things I've done. Not here.
So, Carl set us up once again.
Is he really that
underhanded? God, you killed me.
I just don't know people like that.
You don't know people like this. You married one. You're not harboring some idea this man's coming back to you, are you?
No.
I can't believe you'd be that naive.
But I am not that naive.
He never loved you. He is incapable of it. Let's go home.
Trust a person who can't get mad. That's what my daddy always said.
What are you talking about? I've been mad at you ever since I met you.
No, you haven't. You've been cynical. There's a difference. Can you hear me that?
Getting mad is easy. Living with it is the hard part, because you wouldn't know a thing about that living up on Walton's Mountain.
This is gonna kill me. Just as well as this.
See what I'm talking about?
Eat a cockroach.
You are the most ungrateful woman I have ever met.
Well, at least I don't go around making an ass out of myself trying to be my kid's best friend.
Oh, please, you should talk. At least I didn't lose my kids. Excuse me, do you have a ladies' room?
In the back.
Thanks.
Keep walking. You fight dirty.
Comes from having brothers. You're pretty tough yourself. Listen, Rayanne, I didn't mean what I said about the boys. It was an evil thing to say. Evil and untrue, and I'm sorry.
Yeah. I've heard worse. You forget I used to live with Carl. I didn't mean what I said either.
Hey, you did. And you're right. I have a lot to learn about being a mother. Hell, I got a lot to learn about being a grown-up, but don't tell anybody I said that.
You know, Amanda is a wonderful kid. You gotta be doing something, right?
Go figure. Well, she is what she is in spite of everything. That's the remarkable part. She's not gonna make the same mistakes I did either, I know that. It's just that, you know, every kid deserves a childhood, and Amanda's had precious little of that.
It's the 90s, Holly. Kids grow up fast, faster than you think. I'm not the one you should be telling all this to.
Oh, no, oh, no. Amanda's not going to want to talk to me on call. Hi, Mom, it's me.
Yeah, we're in South Carolina.
Is Amanda around? What? When? Oh, my God. We're on our way. Amanda's run away.
I'm just going to drop you off.
You don't have to do that.
Rain, I don't know how long I'm going to be. I don't even know where I'm going or where I'm going to start.
It's okay. I'm good at this.
I've never been on her own before.
You said yourself she's a smart girl.
She could be sick. She could be in an accident somewhere. Who knows?
Holly, she's going to be okay.
How do you know that? How do you know that? She is 13 years old. Anything could happen to her.
She's a child. She needs a parent.
Wait a minute. I think I know where she might be.
Oh, honey, thank God you're here.
Did you know he was gone?
Yeah.
You knew?
Your letter started coming back months ago. I didn't tell you because I didn't want to hurt you.
You know, you expect me to be adult about everything. But you can't even be straight with me about the one thing that really means anything to me. You can't even tell me my own father's left. I can't tell you how that sucks. You know, you chase after Joey and Robbie's father with a stranger. And you can't even tell me about my own father.
You're right, okay? You're right. I'm a horrible mother. I've made every mistake a mother can possibly make, and I've made your life miserable. I will cop to that. But I am not the one who made your father go away. That is the one thing I will not take the blame for. He did that all by himself. He got up and left us. And the sooner you accept that, honey, the easier your life is gonna be.
You may kiss the bride.
Carl, we may be slow to warm up to, but once you get to know us, I promise you we're a whole lot worse. Well, I'm the oldest, so I get to speak my mind and you get to sit there and like it. I have 3 children. And since Papa died, I like to think that each of them is carrying on his memory in some way. But in a lot of ways, it's you, Holly, who are really carrying on for him. You're the one who got what people love best about him. What we miss the most. Papa's big heart. The way he loved people and people loved him right back. Papa used to call her my little gem. You snared our one and only diamond, Carl. To my daughter and her husband, happiness forever.
Yeah.
You know my gift.
I'm sure it's there.
No, I think
you should do this every
day.
Thank you very much.
I want bacon and
coffee.
How you guys doing?
Good.
Can I come in for a minute?
Sure.
Maybe you can teach Amanda how to do this. I was thinking maybe it's time we all had a talk.
About what?
Well, about what to call each other, for one.
Pop says we should call you Mom.
Is that what you two decided? You know, I always wanted to have a son, and now I have two, so I guess I got what I wanted. And maybe I'll just let you two decide, okay?
Okay. Are you and Daddy going to go away a lot?
I don't think so. Why, did you miss us?
Little.
That's okay. I know what it's like to miss someone. I mean, even when you're as old as me, you can miss somebody.
Who do you miss? Robbie.
It's okay. Well, the person I miss most is my daddy.
Where is he?
Now, he passed away. That's why I know what it's like.
You know, I've been to Atlantic City.
You have?
Yep. When we left Pennsylvania, we went there first.
Oh, you mean Connecticut, right?
Yeah. He's 9. To him, Hawaii's around the block.
Right.
Yeah. Bobby, Joey, lunches. Bye-bye, sweetie. Have a
Bye.
Good day.
Show you around?
School's a school, right?
Honey, it's the finest school in the state. I mean, just think of all the lifelong friends she'll make there.
At 13, lifelong has very little meaning. Right now, her life is ruined.
So what do you want me to do about it?
I don't know yet. Hey, since when do we rent furniture?
Well, since we moved in. How'd you get that?
It was in the mail today. Everything?
No, not everything, just a few things. I mean, it's easier than buying.
The bed?
The bed, no, the bed. The bed's, Salvation Army, I think. I'll take care of that. And I'll talk to Amanda, okay? Maybe I'll even buy her something. With diamonds.
You better not. At least not until you buy me something with diamonds.
Diamonds?
I was just.
These are my personal files. What were you looking for?
I was filing.
Filing?
Yeah, you got this telegram, and I was just going to.
If you need to see something in there, you ask me first.
No, like I said,
I don't need any filing done, Holly. What did you expect to find? Marriage is built on trust.
I know.
I don't want to see your cards. If I see your cards, I might cheat. Yeah, I keep those close to your chest, okay?
Joey.
Rule number one, don't show anyone else
your
cards.
You have a 9.
A 9?
Yeah?
No.
Go fish, go fish!
Sorry. Right. Right, are we all set now? Listen, my husband had this sort of mix-up at the Connecticut store. Yeah, Philadelphia, that's what I meant. Thank you.
I think it's time for Robbie to be promoted to bathroom janitor.
Yeah, we'll see what we can do. Joey, Joe, can I ask you something?
Sure.
You and Robbie don't talk about your mother very much. What was she like?
Well, I don't know. Like you in some ways.
Me?
Yeah.
I'm sure that's a wonderful compliment.
I'm gonna be late for soccer.
And that was in Connecticut, right?
He doesn't want us talking about it.
Who?
Daddy. He doesn't think it's good for us to dwell on the past.
You know, the more you and I get to know each other, the less secrets there'll be. We're family. Wasn't Connecticut, was it?
Get in the car.
Favorite stars.
You can sit there like a rain cloud. You're going to tell me what's troubling you.
Stop trying to read my mind, Mama.
I don't have to. It's all over your face.
Maybe I just want to sit here like mother and daughter. Is that so hard to imagine?
Fiddly sticks. Tell me. It's always the same expression.
Answer the phone, Mama.
I'd hope things would turn out differently with Carl. Mitchell's.
Grandma?
Oh, hi, honey. What's up?
Is Mama there?
Just a sec. It's Amanda.
Hi, baby.
Mama?
Come home now. Amanda! I came home and they were packing.
What?
They're gone.
Do something, Mama?
No, Mama, everything's fine. Delivery man, I had to sign for something. I will. You too. Bye.
We're not telling Grandma.
We're being considerate of her feelings. Besides, tomorrow there'll be nothing to explain anyway. What did he say again?
He said, aside from my boys, you and your mom are the best thing that ever happened to me. You're the daughter I always wanted. And then he drove away. So what now?
You go to school tomorrow.
School? You've got to be kidding.
No, I am not.
I'm going to go look through the store, and I am sure I'm going to find an explanation.
Hi, honey.
So how was your day?
On a scale of 1 to 10? I am so sorry, honey. I thought it was gonna work out this time.
If there's a river out there that you need moved, Holly, I'd like to help you.
All right, but it has to be completely confidential.
Understood.
I do not want to ruin Carl's good name in this town.
I know the perfect person. Owes me a favor.
Okay. Okay, and if it's all the same, I would like to call him myself.
Don't let Mike's personal peculiarities dissuade you. It's a dirty pond these people swim in. If Mike is the best there is in these parts.
He said he was from Connecticut, but you think it was Pennsylvania. Now he's missing, taking all his stuff, the kids, the family Bible, Aunt Minnie's picture, but you're not sure he's really missing.
That's right.